Automated CBC Analyzer. Automated CBC analyzers are computerized, highly specialized equipment for the complete blood count, or CBC, which is perhaps the most common routine baseline investigation. It analyzes the parameters like the red blood cell counts, the white blood cell count, platelet counts, hemoglobin level, hematocrit levels, RBC indices like the red cell distribution width, mean corpuscular volume, mean corpuscular hemoglobin, mean corpuscular hemoglobin concentration, WBC differential count and absolute values, platelet indices like the platelet distribution width, mean platelet volume. Automated CBC analyzers are of two types based on the type of differential white cell count, three-part differential cell counter and the five-part differential cell counter. The three-part differential cell counter functions on the principle of electrical impedance to determine the size and volume of the cells, while the five-part differential cell counter uses flow cytometry and volume conductivity scatter to determine the granularity, diameter, and inner complexity of blood cells. A three-part differential cell counter differentiates the white blood cells into neutrophils, lymphocytes, and the mixed cell count. It is unable to distinguish between monocytes, eosinophils, and basophils, whereas the five-part differential cell counter differentiates white blood cells into neutrophils, lymphocytes, eosinophils, monocytes, and basophils. Principle: automated CBC analyzer aspirates the required quantity of blood, quantifies, classifies, and describes the cell population using both electrical and optical techniques. The three main technologies used in hematology analyzers are photometric method for hemoglobin estimation. RBCs are lysed and hemoglobin released is converted to a colored measurable compound. A monochromatic light from a light source is then passed through the solution. The absorbance of the solution is measured by a photosensor in the hemoglobin flow cell, calculating the hemoglobin concentration. Second is the electrical impedance, also known as Coulter principle, which is used to count the white blood cells, red blood cells, and platelets as they pass through an aperture. As each cell is drawn through the aperture, a change in electrical resistance occurs, generating a voltage pulse. The number of pulses during a cycle corresponds to the number of cells counted, whereas the amplitude of each pulse is directly proportional to the cell volume. The different cell components are depicted in respective histograms as per their size distribution. Histograms are graphical representation of numerical data of the different cell population counted on the cell counter. The x-axis represents the size of the cells in femtoliter, which was assessed by the amplitude of the pulse. The smallest cells, that is, the platelets, are represented on the left side of the histogram, and the largest cell population is represented towards the right side. On a peripheral smear, we assess the cell size by its diameter in mu, whereas, and in an automated analyzer, we assess the cell volume, which is represented in femtoliters. However, the mixed cell population of eosinophils, monocytes are seen left of the neutrophils on the histogram because of the shrinkage of these cells due to stromatolyzer effect. Flow cytometry by volume conductivity scatter, or fluorescent flow cytometry. This is used in the five-part analyzer for white blood cell differential counts. This technique is more expensive due to the expensive reagents. It gives detailed information about the morphology of white blood cells. The principle of flow cytometry by volume conductivity scatter. Besides using impedance principle, 5-part differential cell counters employ flow cytometric principles. Through hydrodynamic focusing, cells are passed through an aperture in a single file. A laser beam then focuses on these cells as they pass in a single file. The absorbance and the scattered light generated by each cell is measured at multiple angles to determine the cell's granularity, diameter, and inner complexities. Based on size, granularity, and nuclear structure, the 5 types of white blood cells are separated in 3-dimensional space and depicted as scattergrams. Scattergram. Scattergram is a 3-dimensional pictorial display of the distribution of the white blood cells based on their size and granularity, causing light scatter. In a scattergram, the x-axis represents the granularity of the cells, thereby pushing agranular cells like lymphocytes and monocytes on the left side of the scattergram. Highly granular cells like the eosinophils are pushed to the extreme right of the scattergram. The y-axis represents the size of the cells, thereby pushing the large cells like monocytes towards the top of the scattergram. Atypical lymphocytes and blast cells will also be seen on the top as they are large cells. Mature neutrophils and basophils are moderately granular and are moderately sized and are found in the mid-zone. The small cells, like nucleated RBCs, the lyse-resistant RBCs, platelet clumps, are seen in the lower left corner or as ghost areas. Fluorescent flow cytometry is used in some instruments where fluorescent reagents are used to identify specific cell populations. The principle is same as that for volume conductivity scatter, and in addition, it uses fluorescent dyes to reveal the nucleus plasma ratio of each stained cell. The added advantage is the analysis of platelets, nucleated RBCs, and reticulocytes.